Today, the likeness of Limestone County Circuit Judge James Edwin Horton, Jr. stands guard over the Limestone County Courthouse. It's the same place where, in the hot summer of 1933, Horton announced a surprising decision that rippled through the courts of America and turned him into an early civil rights hero. Horton, born in 1878 to Confederate veteran and Limestone County probate judge James E. Horton, Sr., was a rising star in Alabama politics when, in 1933, he was appointed to preside over the landmark case that would change his life. The case began 2 years earlier when two young white women accused nine African-American teenagers of raping them on a train rolling through Jackson County, Alabama in March of 1931. The youths, who soon became known internationally as the Scottsboro Boys, were arrested and 2 weeks later tried, found guilty, and sentenced to death. However, the U.S. Supreme Court reversed the convictions on the grounds of incompetent defense and ordered new trials. Horton was appointed to preside over the first retrial of Haywood Patterson beginning March 27, 1933, in the Morgan County Courthouse. The eyes of the world turned to this trial as the Communist Party galvanized defense efforts, organizing protests and spearheading writing campaigns around the world, and hiring the best lawyer in the country, Sam Leibowitz, to represent the teens in court. Large crowds gathered inside the courtroom and on the courthouse grounds, and Horton mobilized sheriff's deputies as well as National Guard troops to protect the boys from lynching attempts. In addressing the all-white, all-male jury selected for the Patterson trial, Horton said, "When it comes to the courts, we know neither native or alien. We know neither Jew nor Gentile. We know neither black nor white, native or foreign-born. But to each it is our duty to mete out even-handed justice." Patterson maintained his innocence, and witness testimony supported his claims. But after an evening of deliberations that included assembling a jigsaw puzzle, the jury found Patterson guilty and sentenced him to death in the electric chair. Rather than setting the execution date, though, Horton suspended it in April of 1933 and postponed the rest of the trials. On June 22, 1933, it was 105 degrees outside when Horton stepped out of his front door and walked a block and a half south in his three-piece suit and boots to the Limestone County Courthouse. He climbed up the marble steps to his courtroom, sat down at his bench, and started reading. He spent 65 minutes reading page after handwritten page of evidence and legal precedent, all leading up to one landmark decision. "It is therefore ordered and adjudged by the court that the motion be granted, that the verdict of the jury in this case and the judgment of the court sentencing this defendant to death be set aside, and that a new trial is hereby ordered." After Horton set aside the verdict and sentence, the Alabama Supreme Court removed Horton from the case and gave it to William Callahan from Coleman. Patterson and the rest of the boys were quickly found guilty, although the U.S. Supreme Court again reversed their convictions in 1935 and ordered new trials because African Americans were excluded from the Patterson jury. By 1950, Patterson had escaped to Michigan, where he died in jail, and the state of Alabama had either dropped charges or pardoned most of the boys. In 2013, the state of Alabama granted the rest of the boys posthumous pardons. Horton had told the jury during the trial, "I have done what I thought to be right as the judge of this court, no matter what the personal cost to me might be." Horton lost his re-election 2 years later, and he never returned to public office, instead moving his antebellum home to Greenbrier in southeastern Limestone County and spending the rest of his days raising Black Angus cattle. But the case made a difference and continues to make a difference in this country today. Patterson versus Alabama was a landmark U.S. Supreme Court case that set the precedent that for black defendants, the jury pool must include African Americans. And Horton, up to his death in 1973, would say, "I learned this phrase at my mother's knee, one she learned from her daddy before her, let justice be done, though the heavens may fall." In October 2017, Athens and Limestone County leaders, along with Horton's family, dedicated the bronze monument of Judge Horton that stands outside the entrance to the Limestone County Courthouse. And on January 4th, 2019, on what would have been Judge Horton's 141st birthday, it was announced that President Donald Trump had signed a bill into law renaming the Athens Post Office as the Judge James E. Horton Jr. Post Office Building.